All right. Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Ankur, who leads MTV Insight Studio, tells me that 2:17 p.m. is the least productive time of the day. And we are sort of lingering around there. So I think we've hit rock bottom and we could only go up from here. I'm here to take you through glimpses of the MTV Insight Studio study, the last edition. But before that, I just wanted to set some context. MTV used to be only a successful TV channel. Now we see ourselves as a youth platform. And I'll tell you why I say that. Around 250 to 300 million people consumed us on television last year. Around 1 billion minutes of our content gets consumed on our OTT app, that is Voot. Around 80 to 100 million people are reached every single month through our social communities. We run offline experiences which are permanent and non-permanent. By permanent, I mean we've licensed club roadies and cafe roadies. By non-permanent, I mean we do A.R. Rahman concert series and Arijit and so on. We also have a licensing deal to do apparel and things like that. So it's pretty much different parts of a young person's life, and hence I'm saying youth platform. And the understanding that all the actions we take on this youth platform are built on this study that we do every 2 years. Just before I start, I wanted to play a couple of videos to just set the mood.
Jill, what is this you keep watching all the day?
Dadu, ye MTV hai. India ka sabse bada youth brand. 450 million people have consumed MTV one way or the other. Inka viewership ek saal mein double ho chuka hai dadu, double. Chakas. अब ये जो रोडीज है लास्ट ईयर 133 मिलियन लोगों ने इसे देखा है. अमेजिंग.
दैट्स रणविजय है ना?
यस दादू, दैट इज रणविजय.
इमेजिन व्हाट दिस यू कीप वाचिंग ऑल द डे.
दादू यार, दिस इज एमटीवी, 450 मिलियन रीच, व्यूअरशिप डबल्ड इन वन ईयर. मेमोरी रिटेन करो दादू, मेमोरी. हेलो अलमंड.
That's running, right?
The running is of the Vijay.
Navin, what is this you keep watching all the day?
Abo yaar, this is MTV. India ka sabse bhavyashali youth brand.
Thank you.
This is MTV. 450 million reach. You should double in 1 year. This is Roadies. Last year, 133 million people saw it.
Naju.
Yes, that's Ranvijay. Ranvijay.
Hey, Naju. What is this?
Kya dekh raha hu? Kuch nahi.
ठीक है, बड़ा स्टिकर लगाओ ना. हम ब्लड डोनर्स का जो डील है ना, बहुत बड़ा होता है. मतलब आपको तो कोई अंदाजा भी नहीं होगा. क्या बताऊं मैं आपको?
वो मैं तो पहले ही बोला, देखो कोई पैसा वैसा नहीं मांगता है. मैंने ब्लड फ्री में डोनेट किया.
अरे मैंने बोला ना उसको, और ब्लड ले लो, मेरे को कुछ नहीं होता है. समझ रहे ना? अभी क्या है कि मैं बहुत लोग के अंदर हूँ, एकदम डीप. अरे आप तो स्वर्ग जा रहे हो. आपका बेटा ब्लड डोनर बन गया ना. सर आना रोडीज, मैं सिर्फ 100% नहीं देता, खून भी देता हूँ एज अ ब्लड डोनर. मुझे ऐसे लगता है कि ये सब. हाँ ब्रो.
ए, 10 दिन हो गए, खून दिया है किडनी नहीं.
हाँ ब्रो. हाँ तो मैं वो, अरे मैं बोल रहा हूँ ना, ब्लड मैंने दिया है ना. तुझे दिया ही नहीं, तेरे को थोड़ी ना.
मम्मी, अगर इंडिया सबसे बेस्ट है तो आप दीदी का अमेरिका क्यों भेज रहे हो? मम्मी, अगर इंडिया सबसे सुंदर है तो हम अगर फॉरेन वेकेशन के लिए क्यों जाते हैं? कैच. मम्मी, अगर इंडियन इंजीनियर सबसे बेस्ट है तो हमारी रोड जितनी खराब क्यों? मम्मी, कबर्ड में इतने सारे कैश के बंडल्स क्यों पड़े हैं? पापा ने पुलिस अंकल को पैसे थैंक यू बोलने के लिए दिए थे.
मेरी दीदी अलग ग्लास से पानी क्यों पीती है? प्याज इतना महंगा क्यों है?
मम्मी तैमूर बॉलीवुड का अगला किंग बनेगा।
क्या बात है, वो तो बड़ा हो गया। आई टेल यू करण ने ना
डिस्ट्रैक्ट मत होना, इंपॉर्टेंट सवाल पूछते रहो। हैप्पी रिपब्लिक डे।
मम्मी
So, that was just to give you an idea about the personality of the brand and the tone of voice that we use. Now, the Insight Studio has been doing this Insight study with youth for the last 15 odd years. So, what that gives us is, it gives us access to data on the stress, concern, hopes, aspirations of youth across the years. And what that lets us do is see how things have moved between different generations. And from the latest study, I'll try and paint three or four themes that emerge. Okay, so there are four themes I would want to talk about. The first one is Mera Bharat Banega Amaze Balls. A second is a perspective on Bharat versus India. A third is Girl on Top. The fourth is about family. And the fifth is some individual traits of this person. In our study, one thing that we figured is the friction or the push and pull on this young person that leads to a lot of decisions or the way they behave is A, this fast-paced, modern, dynamic world and the need to be progressive, where young people feel that, of course, I need to be progressive, both in my behavior and in my mindset. But at the same time, there's a massive surge in my pride and my traditions. So the push and pull between the push of wanting to be very progressive and the pull of traditions, which may at some times make you be seen, if not really a bit regressive, that push and pull in our mind really is the churn that's happening, that's leading to some of the insights that we talk about. The first one is Mera Bharat Banega Amazeballs. Banega because young people believe that there's a lot that's good, but they're equally aware of the lot that's bad, and they believe we are the ones who are going to make it better, and hence Banega. First one is, like I said, massive surge in pride, in culture and traditions, and they manage to distinguish between traditions and religion. Tradition is something that gives me a sense of belonging, something we do together, but religion mostly seems to be something that should be private or may polarize, and hence the distinction. A lot of this has got to do with A, the political discourse wanting to put India on the global stage, and some of that seems to have trickled down. It's also little things like when the Empire State Building or Niagara Falls or the Burj Khalifa and so on, everything gets bathed in the tricolor on Republic Day as a mark of respect. All of that floods down social media down into the deepest corners. And young people start to believe that, oh, India's really arrived on the global stage. We are being recognized everywhere. Indians read about exports like yoga or Ayurveda on the global stage and how it's being taken up on a mass scale. And then they believe that, oh, there's so much fantastic about our culture. They hear about people who are famous in the glamour industry, and that's another takeout. They hear about Sundar Pichai, and they hear about big business leaders who are from India. And that's again something that reinforces this in their mind. So that leads to a lot of optimism. From 2 years back, if let's say 37% of young people felt optimistic about their future, right now 65% are feeling much more optimistic. And part of this optimism is driven from an action orientation. So if there's one thing that's definitely very different about this generation from previous generations, it's the ability to be action oriented. So if let's say 5 years back, a young person of the same age was okay being a clicktivist, was okay voicing his or her opinion only on social media, this is a generation that seems to be wanting to go out and do things themselves. And they do it because they seem to be having an understanding that if I keep waiting for somebody else to do it, whether it's authority or government or a municipal corporation or my neighbor, it's never going to happen. We'll have to do this together is something that's new to this generation. And some of the examples here, whether it's Siddharth Mandala, who created a footwear that lets off a charge when you attack, or even yesterday, if you read the papers, young Pawan in Uttar Pradesh, who's planning to run from Lucknow to Allahabad, that's 200 kilometers, because he believes in conservation of forests. There are many, many examples. Aranya Johar, who does slam poetry, Deepesh Tank, who wore spy glasses in local trains in Mumbai to capture Eve teasers and then got them arrested. The common thread for all this is young people seem to have decided that it's time for us to act. And this study predates some of the action that you're seeing on ground. So the groundswell was always there of young people feeling that we're going to act. A second part where we went in thinking that maybe Bharat and India might be going in massively different directions. But in a nutshell, what we found is that what young people in small towns are looking for is really big city success in small towns.
Why not? एक ट्रेडमिल लगाते हैं जिम जाना हो ही नहीं पता यार
वहां वो क्लिम्बिंग वाला लगाएंगे
यहां मैं डंबल मारूंगा और आईना वहां लगाएंगे
और यहां पर मैं वो गर्म पानी का बाथ
इधर नहीं यहां मुझे योगा के लिए जगह चाहिए
अच्छा ठीक है मैं ऑनलाइन अरे बेटा तेरे मुंबई जाने के बाद इस रूम का क्या करना है वो डिसाइड करो
मुंबई जॉब ऑफर आई है तुझे वहां की एमएनसी से मैं वो जॉब ऑफर नहीं ले रहा हूं एक्चुअली मैं इंदौर छोड़कर जाना ही नहीं चाहता मुझे खुद का स्टार्टअप शुरू करना है यही से आप एवरीथिंग व्हाट आई नीड यू और टाइम आ गया है कि यहां का टैलेंट यही कुछ करे ना कि मुंबई वापस
तुझे लिविंग रूम में सोने में बड़ा मजा आएगा
काले हेयर ए नो 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 ए आई एम एमबीए वाह वाह अब मैं क्या है मेरा अपना
पराया So again, in their mind space, young people have started believing that the opportunities in small towns are pretty much getting there in terms of what the metros really offer. And by now, everybody has either a relative or has themselves traveled to the metros. They know what the big city life brings with it. The anonymity in your ecosystem, the long hours of travel, the crumbling infrastructure. So when they compare that with where they are, which is 15-20 minutes across the whole town, you know everybody around you, and the benefits of staying with family, they suddenly seem to be clear that this is where I want to make it ideally. And I don't think going to a big city is really what's going to cut it. Might be too early to predict the end of migration, but if Jio has brought a telecom revolution where everybody down to the last mile is able to use mobile internet, and Amazon is saying that we managed to send goods to every single corner of the country, it just reinforces the fact that everything I need is equally available whether I'm in a metro or I'm in a small town. A third theme that we picked up really was girl on top. I'll just play a video for you.
Rohan Shah, Umar, Mandy, Rohan Sinha. वो कॉलेज फेस्ट वाला कौन था यार
मुकुल
मुकुल कॉल वाला बियर्डो प्लीज तो कभी उत्सव से नहीं मिली थी ना इसलिए 3-4 पर नहीं आना ही वाज क्यूट यार आई मीन बेटर देन दैट बाल की दुकान यू डेटेड जुबिन
जुबिन दैट्स व्हाट आई बीन फॉरगेटिंग ओके सो इट्स मंगेश राजबीर
मैंडी ऑफ कोर्स एंड जुबिन
ओके
दो चार ही हुए थे पांच थे ना
हाँ पांच थे शर्मा को बैठे हूँ
सुबोध सुबोध एमबीए क्लास वाला
हाँ जी क्लास
दिए
कटे पास में आप
So while women seem to be opening up the shackles for themselves, to me this number is really telling, which is 4 years back, fewer women believe that same relationship rules need to apply to a boy and girl. And that number has really become almost 100 now, where now increasingly women across the board believe that, listen, the rules need to be equal. again, something we picked up, which is girls seem to believe that parents have become modern in their outlook much more. And what seems to be happening is that the girl in the house seems to have the time and the patience to be able to navigate her parents through technology and a mobile phone and the mobile internet. And in doing that, there is a very peer-to-peer or an educational sort of conversation. And that's leading to parents believing that the girl is adding so much more value to my life and in the family. And in return, they are rewarding, in a sense, the girl with asking her on a lot many more things what her opinion is. And that's leading to her feeling that, okay, my parents are so much more modern. And like I said, some of the categories where this seems to have made a difference is that girls have started believing that even in high value purchases like maybe electronics or automobiles or a car or even a financial instrument, these are categories where people have started believing, or girls have started believing, that they have a major say on the decision their parents make. A fourth theme that we picked up, and I'm just rattling through because I'm mindful of this 0 seconds that's staring at me, is the return of family, which doesn't mean that family went anywhere, but a return to a traditional way of living, and I'll tell you what I mean. A first one is a positive attitude towards arranged marriage amongst young people, and that stems from the fact that the arranged marriage game has changed. It's like arranged love marriage. You don't have to decide in one meeting. There are multiple meetings. You could be chatting online. There's no pressure, and so on and so forth. So because the process has gotten a bit liberalized, there seems to be a much more attitude towards this thing. A second one is young people seem to now want to stay with their parents a lot more. In the study 4 years back, when we checked this, most young people said we want to branch out and live on our own. Now young people seem to want to live with their parents, and there's a very rational argument for that. In this dynamic chaos that we call life, they see the merit of the house being run by parents. The other thing we pick up is that young people increasingly are facing mental health hazards. If you believe the psychologists that we've been speaking to, then there is an epidemic that is underreported, and that's caused primarily by two factors. The first one being young people unable to sort of delineate between social media and reality, where they start feeling that everybody else's life is so fantastic and my life is zero, and you know, I've lost it, it's all over for me. So that sort of feeling leading to one sort of hazard. A second one is anxiety in the workplace for first jobbers. In the first 12 to 18 months, young people seem to be struggling to cope up with the demands of the workplace. So they start feeling like, I am underskilled, I don't think I'll be able to cut it in this organization, whichever level you look at it. And those things are again leading to young people feeling that family, the support system, that ecosystem is really critical. So 3-4 years back, when we asked people a forced choice between career and family, what's really important, it was a neck and neck, a photo finish. But last time when we asked them, really, it's tilted in favor of family, and that's for the reasons that I mentioned to you. Family is a very critical rational argument, and there's an emotional argument as well. Certain things about the individual traits that you might have picked up: more and more people seem to believe that money is not everything. I need to be living multiple lives. Money, 10 years back when you asked them, 90-92% people were saying, if I have money, I will be happy. Now only around 40-50% say, if I have money, that's the only criteria for happiness. The new currency for success and happiness seems to also be legacy, which is, what's the narrative I have created? What's the story that people are discussing when it comes to me? What's the impact I'm leaving behind? So legacy seems to be the new currency, and hence I would like to do something meaningful with my life, rather than be only rich and successful. And lastly, these young people seem to be reasonably happy, much more than ever before, and family is the primary reason for their happiness, much more than personal achievements. So in a nutshell, if I were to give them 6-7 key labels or takeaways, then this is the young Indian that we have discovered. This is an abridged version due to lack of time. Happy to catch up offline and discuss in detail, or even, you know, over a cup of coffee. Thank you.